Hello and welcome to this massive open online course, an introduction to biorisk management. I am your instructor Kenneth, and in this short segment I will be discussing the structure and organization of a biosafety laboratory. Now, most biosafety laboratories are governed by a specific institutional biosafety committee. This institutional biosafety committee is responsible for developing the policies for that specific facility. The biosafety committee is in turn supported by the facility managers, the biosafety officers, and other departments which may be relevant to the functioning and operation of that facility. Let's see how this process begins. So, when deciding to set up a biosafety laboratory, one needs to take into account the cost of the facility. Operating biosafety facilities involves a significant amount of expenditure in setting up as well as in operation of the facility. Now, in this slide, I'm going to show you how the organizational structure looks in general. So, at the top of this slide, we have the IBC, Institutional Biosafety Committee, which comprises the administrators as well as technical experts. These, in turn, supervise the operation of the facility via the facility manager. Now, the facility manager should essentially be a qualified engineer who is aware of the operation of the facility. The facility manager operates the facility as well as engages in routine maintenance and emergency maintenance as the case may be. It is important that he or she be aware of the biosafety procedures, even though they may be from an engineering background. Now, the second most important pivot in this management structure is the science officer or the biosafety officer. Now, biosafety officers are specifically trained in the management of facility in terms of the risk assessment, risk mitigation, and performance assessment. They are critical to the operation of the facility, and they should be given the authority to flag any breaches of containment or any violations in procedures. Now, a biosafety officer essentially facilitates the operation of the facility. He or she cannot be expected to develop specific policies for management of certain risk groups or risk agents. This is the responsibility of the principal officer or the principal investigator. The principal investigator is the individual who will conduct experiments and procedures at the facility. So here we have the basic structure: the Institutional Biosafety Committee supervising the overall functioning of the laboratory, the facility manager who looks after the mechanical operation of the facility, the biosafety officer who looks after the risk assessment, risk mitigation and performance assessment, and the principal investigator who is responsible for the actual experiments itself. Now, all of these three components function below the IBC and they need to work in synchronicity with each other. And what needs to be understood is that in the facility itself, the biosafety officer is the one who has the authority to oversee operations. Speaking about this structure, I move on now into the policy itself. It is very important that every biosafety facility has a specific biosafety policy, which indicates the commitment of the organization to both biosafety and biosecurity at that respective facility. A biosafety policy in itself has to be written so as to be specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-based. So this policy will govern the next instrument, which is the biosafety manual. Now, biosafety manuals are specific to a facility. And biosafety manuals are basically written based on specific guidelines. So, for instance, at our facility, we use the WHO guidelines, the BMBL guidelines, as well as guidelines from the NIH and any local agency. In our case, we use CIRM standards. In your particular location, you may have to use specific standards based on your national or state requirements. That is basically how the structure of a biosafety facility is set up. You have an administration and you have the officers who execute the basic functions. Now, having said that, one comes down to the aspect of cost. The cost of a facility has two components, the operational costs as well as the cost of establishment. Establishment costs can be quite high, and the operational costs basically add to the operating cost for every experiment that is conducted at the facility. When designing the facility, please ensure that you have designed it taking into consideration the cost of maintenance, because setting up a facility is one thing, but operating it is another thing. This is a short segment which I have developed for you in order to explain informally the process of facility management. You can refer to my lecture notes, which will describe what I have stated in detail. Thank you very much for watching this segment, and please stay biosafe.